Pastor Kwong. So more than just a football player, Sacred Seeds, bring in health, community, empowerment, enrichment, nourishment, all of this to the globe. All right, so now you put out a call in the last segment for some help because you're doing these sustainable greenhouses, community gardens around the city of Philadelphia, but you're actually looking to make this a global initiative.
Yes.
And so sometimes we talk about learning about patience and pacing and projects and so forth. And so for right now, for those people who are interested, in one way or another, whether it's actually coming out and clearing space, if it's planting some of these sacred seeds, if it's helping with the aquaponics, if it's, what's the best way for them to get in contact with you?
Yeah, so we're on all social media, at The Sacred Seeds, T-H-E, Sacred Seeds, thesacredseeds.org, that's our website, and if you are feeling like you really want to get involved, you can email the organization's email at plantaseed@thesacredseeds.org.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Are they doing any crowdfunding or thinking
about doing that? Yeah, so in the next week, maybe couple weeks, we'll distribute our initiative, which is our seed lab initiative.
Okay.
You know, we look at the greenhouses we're trying to erect as seed labs, and all the youth and different members of the community that will be in there as a sacred scientist.
Yeah.
So this is for,
I just had a vision. I saw the coats and the goggles. Yeah, I saw it.
And with that, it's not only are we going to try to grow to increase access, grow to provide educational experiences, but it's also research and development as well.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to utilize the space and we'll have aquaponics, hydroponics, soil-based, non-soil-based, and start to look at what methods work the best. And, you know, we also want to provide a variety of different ways to grow for the people that are coming in to cultivate with us. So, yeah, that's the Seed Lab Initiative, hoping to erect a greenhouse in Kensington, Philadelphia, designated food desert by the USDA. And, you know, it's something that once that is up, it provides a sustainable movement, because once you get that first batch of produce out, you know, you can sell the surplus back to the local restaurants, and then obviously make sure that the members of the community are getting what they need and are getting fulfilled as well. And
yeah.
I think once we get that up, will be able to expand exponentially.
Yeah. I know one of the things you mentioned was the children being the demographic that you were really targeting. Curriculum-based learning as well?
Yep. So we've been fortunate enough to have members of the community that are already doing what we're trying to do, provide curriculums and in some cases provide hands-on teaching, you know? So we're fortunate to have all these pieces in play, and at this point it's just about getting the funds to get the actual base greenhouse up and allow all these different pieces to come together and start, you know, growing the future, you know, cultivating change, striving to thrive. You know, all these are...
Oh, he's pulling out all these sacred seeds.
And that's the thing, because, you know, obviously, you know, these days we use these things for hashtags and whatnot, but it's also an opportunity to continue to reiterate to ourselves the importance of growing the future, cultivating change. These words are not new. They've always been in our existence.
Yep.
We may have forgotten them and been distracted by, you know, other forces at play. You know, so Sacred Seeds is just trying to do their part and encourage a cohesive, collaborative environment and approach, so that every player, if you will, you know, like the soccer, it's 10 players plus a goalie on the field. You need every single player to get the win. So that's
right.
How we look at it. We're just another position on the field, and you know, we're looking for our teammates, essentially. Yes.
And this is something that you yourself are also actively involved. It's not just a nonprofit where other people are going to do the work. You are also actively participating.
participating.
Oh yeah, hands are dirty, dirt under the fingernails. We had an event last Saturday with the True Way Foundation at the Lenfest Center.
Yes.
We brought our own sacred seed. Luckily, thanks to little Adam, I gotta give him a shout out. Local microgreen grower that's given us his bedroom to start tweaking our formula, and we've got some sunflower shoots, wheatgrass growing.
Okay.
We got to pass out some wheatgrass shots at this event.
Uh-huh.
Love seeing the impact it had on people. Mm-hmm. People really like legit felt energized after it. So
it's amazing.
So it shows we're on the right track, and, yes. And I love how we started small, and you know, I said it earlier, it's about instead of trying to reach outwards too fast, you know, let the roots reach downward, supplant themselves. Connect to the neural network, and that's what's going to open up the pathways for us to truly reach for the light.
Yes, yes. All right. So as you're reaching for the light, let's talk a little bit about being light on your feet.
Light on my feet.
How's the rest of the season
looking
for you?
Yep. So we're about halfway through the season. Philadelphia Union, we're fighting for playoff contention right now. I personally am very excited for this next half because I feel more energized and I feel like I can really start to provide impact and be a little bit more productive in front of the goal.
Mm-hmm.
And we recently just advanced in a local tournament, the U.S. Open Cup.
Yep.
So this is a cup that's for the best team in America. It includes amateur teams as well.
Okay.
We're into the quarterfinals of that. And so yeah, we're pushing to bring some hardware to Philadelphia. The Eagles, you know, got the city really hype off of their win. They got us really hyped. The Sixers had a really good season.
Yeah. Then Villanova followed up.
Villanova, it's cool because now they're coming to our games and showing love too. So it's just about us getting the city to get behind us as well.
Yeah.
You know, soccer is up and coming sport.
Mm-hmm.
It's not historically one of the sports that in a city you're gonna see a lot of people supporting, but
mm-hmm.
that's up to us, you know, to continue to provide a product on the field that makes people want to come
to
the games.
That's right.
Yep.
So website people should check out to find the schedule.
PhiladelphiaUnion.com.
Mm-hmm.
Also, you know, if you want to follow a little bit more in depth kind of behind the scenes of players view, you can follow me on Instagram. That's at CJ Sapong. Try to keep it light and juicy for y'all.
Okay.
And yeah, that's pretty much it.
All right. Well, I love soccer really for one of the main reasons, and that's when someone scores.
Mm, the goal.
Give it to them.
The goal. The goal.
Goal.
Goal. Goal. Goal. Goal. Goal. Goal. Goal. Goal. Ended the back right now, shaking his head, but it's all good, y'all.
That's right.
It's all good.
That's right. It's all good. So thank you so much for being with us today, for sharing everything that you share, what you do as far as with Sacred Seeds, obviously also being an inspiration to a lot of youth and to families who are into sports and football and so forth. And of course, here at Green Street Animal Care, we love the fact that you are a happy dog lover owner.
Yes.
All right. So until we meet again, you have been watching Dr. Walls and Friends. Take care, God bless, and continue to live your greatest life.
Mm.